Hi, my name is Megan Rossman. I'm the public horticulture intern here at the Scott Arboretum. And on this lovely warm spring day, we are going to be going over pruning for hydrangeas, the hydrangea arborescens, macrophylla, paniculata, and quercifolia. So we're going to start with hydrangea arborescens. We have a specific cultivar here, NCHA2, Invincible Spirit to Smooth Hydrangea. And so when you're looking at hydrangea arborescens, what you are seeing is 1 year growth. So all of these stems and these panicles, this is one season's growth. And so with these, you want to cut them kind of in February to March, unless cold temperatures persist. Obviously, we don't want to stress out the plant more, and if it's continually cold and you prune it, it just is going to put more stress on the plant when it needs to develop. So we've had some warm temperatures lately, so we're going to go ahead and prune it. And what we do with these is we prune them all the way down to the ground, leaving about 6 inches. And we like to cut above a node, that way you don't have kind of some weird stems hanging out and growth coming beneath it. So cut right above the node, and we'll get in close here to kind of show how to cut it. So when looking at the plant, you can see along the stem that there are various nodes. There's usually two little nodes on either side and kind of a line that goes across the stem. This is where new growth is going to come out. So there's nodes all along the stem, and if you go towards the base, you can actually see where we have last year's cuts. So we don't want to cut all the way to the ground because we want to encourage growth from these nodes. So I'm going to look at nodes that are closer to last year's cuts and just cut right above them, not cutting off the nodes, but just right above the closer to the ground nodes. This allows growth from these two points to come up, and it's gonna leave the plant a lot more full without kind of having these awkward stems hanging above. So I'm just gonna cut down right above the nodes, close to the ground, but I don't wanna cut away what I did last year because I want to have this plant have a good success rate in sprouting in the new season. Cut back this hydrangea arborescens. We have our panicles and stems here, which do make really nice like dried flower arrangements, so you can keep them or compost them. But what we've done here is pretty much cut it back, obviously not all the way to the ground. We've left a little bit of the old growth and some new growth here as well. So again, we cut just right above the nodes, and remember that each of these lines, these node areas, two stems are going to come out of that. And so we must remember that we kind of just doubled this plant and how many stems are going to be coming up. So we have to consider that it may get a little bit overcrowded. And so you may want to come back once you've swept away the leaves and thin it out a little bit if you think it's going to be too overcrowded. We could definitely clean this up a little bit more, but this is kind of your basic cutting for the hydrangea arborescens. You want to take it almost all the way to the ground and cut above those nodes for a nice clean look. So similar to the hydrangea arborescens, the hydrangea paniculata, you want to cut back in March to February to March. Again, if cold temperatures are persisting, I would hold off on pruning, but if you're starting to see warm days, that's a great day to prune because you want to get it kind of before new growth is going to start. So this is hydrangea paniculata silver dollar. It's one of kind of our classic plantings here in the Scott Arboretum entrance garden. You know, beautiful white plumes that persist all the way through the winter, kind of adding that winter interest, but it's time for them to go because we need to kind of usher in that new growth. So with the paniculata, what you're seeing is definitely a more woody structure than we saw with the arborescens. This is multiple years of growth. With the arborescens, we kind of cut them almost all the way back to the ground. This we're pruning for, you know, we want to help gain its shape, and we're looking to prune for structure. So we do want to cut it back at the nodes because we want new growth to come up. We're also pruning to really kind of give it its structure and help it maintain its optimal height. If we didn't prune these, they would get tall and wild and bushy because they're just going to keep growing. So we want to keep them at kind of our optimal height for their cultivar. And silver dollar, this is this great optimal height. So we're going to go in, we're going to kind of look at the nodes, and we're going to prune in the way that's both keeping the shape, but also making sure that we're thinking of thinning out inside branches, so we're not going to have crossing branches, and we're kind of really going to help to create a nice clean look for this plant. So Hydrangea paniculata, silver dollar. You can see where we have past year's pruning. So it looks like we pruned right here above the node and we had two branches come out from that node. So what I'm gonna do is, here's a node right here. I want this branch to come out a little bit, so I could choose to cut at this node or this node. I'm gonna cut up at this one because I wanna be a little bit more on the conservative side. We can always cut it back more, but we can't cut it back less. So I'm gonna kinda take these nodes like this. This branch to me is a little bit odd because it's growing kind of through the plant. So I'm actually just gonna take this one off fully. So I'm cutting right at the base. Why I chose to take this one out again is because it was cutting through the plant. I don't want rubbing branches. I don't want anything that's kind of growing through the plant because that's gonna make the structure a little odd. And we wanna really emphasize these plants that are growing in the middle. So I'm gonna just go through. I'm gonna cut two nodes up maybe from where the last cut was because I wanna give myself room to edit. So we've taken off the panicles and about a third of the growth. So you can see I have kind of cleared up space on the inside. Again, every place that I cut at these nodes, above these nodes, there's gonna be two branches that grow. So I really wanna be, you know, conscientious of how this is going to fill out. So I've cut back some of the smaller stuff where I'm like, I don't know if that's going to really contribute to the shape of this plant. And I've really kind of left these stronger branches that I know are going to produce nice full flowers and good stems. I've been a little bit more on the conservative side, cutting about 2 to 3 nodes up. And that allows me to be able to come back after a couple days and be like, you know, I'm not loving the shape of this. I want to edit it a bit. So I would always say, leave a little bit more leeway to come back rather than cutting it down too short. Again, every one of these nodes is gonna produce about 2 new branches. So this is gonna be nice and full. Again, we're gonna do this like the Hydrangea arborescens in February and March when it starts to warm up. So I'm sitting next to Hydrangea macrophylla, City Line Berlin, or Big Leaf Hydrangea. And what we can see is a little bit more of a woody structure again. And we can actually already start to see growth. So what we see up here are usually flower buds, and then we can see a couple other bigger flower buds along the stem, and the littler ones are actually going to be leaves. So this hydrangea is a little bit less winter hardy above ground. So if you had a really harsh winter, a lot of this might actually die to the ground while still remaining root hardy. So it would survive underground, but this would need to be cut back because it might be falling over. It had gotten frozen. This year, unfortunately, we had a really, you know, easy winter. And so this, all the growth above ground has stayed, you know, nice and fresh. This hydrangea flowers on old wood. So this is old wood from last year. And so right now we're actually not going to prune this because there's nothing broken that we can see. There's nothing dead that we can see. All the stuff that we have here has buds on it. And so we're not going to prune it unless for some reason we get some freak freeze and this all dies. Then we would want to prune it back. But I really would say be delicate with these. Don't go heavy on the pruning unless you're sure something is dead or broken, and wait to make sure that something is dead or broken until it starts really sprouting buds. Again, if you want to prune for shape or structure, you can do that after the blooms come. So I would say in the fall, because remember, every time you cut something in the spring, you're cutting away the blooms. So right now we're gonna leave our hydrangea macrophyllas for unless we get some storm and this all dies. So this is Hydrangea quercifolia Snow Queen, or our oak leaf hydrangea. This is a beautiful hydrangea. It's got really lovely white panicles, kind of those oak-shaped leaves. And because of its south-facing placement, it actually gets that beautiful burgundy leaf color in the fall. But now it has just a little bit of its panicles left. There are a couple leaves on here. And what I want to emphasize with the quercifolia is, unless you're pruning for structure, and or there's obviously dead or broken branches, leave this guy alone in the spring. So we are not gonna look to prune any dead or broken branches until stuff starts sprouting, because we wanna make sure that what we're cutting back is actually dead or broken. We don't wanna be cutting back our flowers. So you do start to see panicles and some leaves on here. What we do at the Scott Arboretum, at least around the entrance garden, is we leave these alone. This plant will drop those panicles and drop those dead leaves when it starts to sprout. So you certainly could, if you really wanted to and you don't like the look of this, come around and take off these panicles. But we're just gonna leave them because we know it's gonna drop them on their own. The quercifolia are really a very structural plant. They bloom on old wood. And so when you're cutting back stuff in the spring, you have to remember that if you cut off a live branch, you're cutting back flowers and potential blooms for that year. So we would only really prune this for structure in the fall to kind of help the shape of this plant. But in the spring, we're gonna wait until we start seeing buds and blooms to cut back any dead or broken branches. Otherwise, we're really gonna leave this guy alone. So that is our gardener's almanac for pruning hydrangeas for arborescens, paniculata, macrophylla, and quercifolia. Thank you so much for joining us here at the Scott Arboretum, and we will see you for the next gardener's almanac.